better offensively?
Yeah, is there something on that offensive end that you guys thought you were missing that maybe did better against Washington State?
Just all around execution, I would say. Getting into our flow and playing our own game, not letting ourselves get disrupted and just playing to our strength.
Yeah, just doing the little things. I mean, our coaches do a great job, you know, every day preaching what we need to do, and we just haven't translated it, you know, exactly like we want to on the court. So that's on us. We're going to, you know, get back this week and work on and continue to progress in that.
I know it's hard to quantify, but what difference do you think it would have made having Kelsey in there? What would Kelsey have added that maybe was missing?
I mean, I think the number one thing, you know, she's like one of our, if not our best leader. She's a very vocal leader. You know, she's like the heart and sweat of our team. And we've obviously been missing that. But I think she's a great defensive player. So I think she would have really helped us on the defensive end. You know, wouldn't let, you know, Osar get going or Plum get going. She just really keys in on, you know, the top players and stuff like that. And then, I mean, on offense, she does her job and does the dirty work for our team. And that's what we're kind of missing right now. So we just got to continue to pick it up and fill that void until she comes back.
Riley went down in the fourth quarter. What kind of momentum swing do you think that made? Because she pretty much had the assignment of guarding Plum to that point, and then Plum ultimately went off. But what do you guys think was the biggest breaking point in Riley going down the fourth?
I mean, anytime you never want to see a teammate go down. I don't think it comes down to one player making all the difference. It's a team thing, but of course, it's never good to see someone go down.
Yeah, I mean, it's tough, you know, when your starting point guard goes down like that, but we need to do a better job of picking it up and, you know, filling that spot for her, so.
Anything else? You talked a little bit about
Osar.
You guys still had 36 or 34 original rebounding, but just to have one player get 20 rebounds, you don't see that very often. Against you guys, that just doesn't happen. Is it, you know, is it just that difficult to, you know, box out or just your physicality? What is it that allows her to have that kind of rebounding?
I mean, like we both said earlier, you know, she's just a really great player, and she works hard for what she does, but it's kind of like a mentality when you guard her. You just have to be more determined than her not to get the ball. You have to stay disciplined and box her out. You know, she's big and she uses her body for getting rebounds, and she's really good at what she does. So we just, you know, personally, I didn't do my job on her. She got a lot of offensive rebounds on me, and that's something that, you know, can't happen if we want to beat them. And 20 rebounds for one player is not okay in our program. So we're going to have to adjust to that and get back to hitting people first and rebounding hard.
Thank you.
trying to find a picture because his birthday is tomorrow on Instagram, but I couldn't find one.
Oh, well, that was a great battle. That was a critical juncture when it was a one possession game and Riley Richardson went down. I didn't quite see the play, but that was tough, you know, because she's really doing such an amazing job running our team, running the show, and that hurt us because we also are kind of with a four guard rotation right now. So we got a little tired, and but, you know, I'll just say, you know, I thought Sophie and Quinn have been so amazing for us and just carrying the day. And obviously, you know, they just kind of struggled today a little bit with their offense. And that, you know, that was hard because we rely so much on them offensively. I thought our guards actually did a pretty good job of holding down the fort. And just glad we get to play these guys again. I mean, obviously, they're a great team and they got the better of us today. But it was a great game. And I figured it would go down to the wire, and I'm pretty sure it would have if Riley hadn't gotten hurt. But, you know, next time we play him, hopefully Kelsey will be back and be at full strength and we can make some adjustments. We didn't quite execute our game plan, although we did. You know, if you took out the fouls at the end, I think we held them about 27 points below their average. So we just got to clean some things up offensively. And I think we can do a lot better, actually, defensively. You know, I knew it would be a challenge for these young guards to, you know, guard a player like Plum, and it was. And then we just didn't really have good help in team defense like we wanted to at times. So some good takeaways from this game. Obviously, it's a tough road ahead, and we just got to weather January, you know, without Kelsey Moose, without our, you know, tough senior leader, because we got four in a row on the road at two of the toughest places, the Bay Area and L.A. So we just got to work hard, weather it, keep trying to get better, and just – hope and pray that we can move into February fully healthy and playing our best basketball.
Questions? How much of a learning experience was this for the young guards going against someone like Kelsey
Plum? I mean, definitely the best player they've had to guard all year. And, you know, I mean, look at our conference. And it's just going to get, you know, I mean, you got Weiss, you got Canada, you know, and obviously they've been up against, you know, some really good players already. But, I think, you know, just, you know, another top 10 team, you know, and I thought, well, based on the last time we played one, we did a lot better. But, yeah, I think it'll be better the second time around for them. It's hard. We didn't, you know, we're so short on our rotation right now when we only had one day to prepare. We really didn't do much on the court physically. So I just tried to mentally. We watched a lot of film. We sort of prepared them. I think you kind of have to experience it. So that's a great question. And I think, you know, I think next time around they're going to be a little bit more adept, or maybe, you know, a little bit more ready. Maybe take away her left hand a little better. Maybe not.
She's moved past some pretty big names in scoring.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think so. Absolutely. One of the all-time great scorers in our conference and in the country. You know, she just does a great job. I mean, she can, you know, shoot the three, mid-range, get to the rim. And, you know, she's developed her game every year. She's gotten better. And she finds her teammates better than she ever has. So, you know, she's definitely a great challenge to guard.
She said that all the records are nice for beating you guys.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah.
what kind of, I asked the players too, what kind of difference do you think Kelsey would have made? Just, it's hard to quantify, I know, but.
Well, we'll see next time we play her, play them. I mean, Kelsey's from Washington, so I'll just leave it at that. She makes a huge difference when we play the Washington teams, because that one moment when we needed someone out there to say, let's go and let's step up and take this game, nobody did it. And that's what Kelsey does for us. So we missed it. You know, regardless of how many points she scores and how many rebounds she gets, she's our emotional leader, and we missed her today.
Your team was outscored by 10 in the paint today, and also Jorge had 20 rebounds of her own. Could you just speak to what was the collapse of protecting the paint from tonight?
Collapse? What were the stats? I don't know. How many points did they have in the paint? 42, yeah. That's more than we've been giving up. I mean, obviously they're shooting, you know, this. We really strategized to take away the three in this game, and they were 4 for 21. So we did a good job of that. We held them 27 points below their average. So obviously where they were going to give up a few more points in the paint. But our help side was not good because of our focus on the three-point shooting, so we may need to adjust some things. And we didn't execute our game plan. The help that was supposed to be there wasn't there on 10 or 0. So we just had defensive breakdowns. Again, the one day to prepare was tough. I mean, you can't look past Washington State. I mean, they were too good coming into our place, and we prepared fully for them. And it's just a quick turnaround when most of your players haven't played a team of that level, you know, and don't know the personnel as well. But, you know, we need to box out better. That's my big takeaway. You know, we don't usually give up the putbacks and the second shots, and, you know, we haven't been boxing out. Even though we've been controlling the boards amazingly well, we've been on our post players to box out better, and it finally caught up with them. And so I think that's a great takeaway for us more than anything, because, you know, it was going to be tough to contain Plum, you know, but that's something you can control, the rebounding, I think. And we didn't the way we do. I mean, we've been plus about 16, and we were plus 2. And I think the other key to the game was we didn't take care of the ball this week. You know, we've been doing a great job of taking care of the ball most of the conference season, and this week we didn't do a good job, and, you know, you just can't give those extra possessions. I mean, I think this is definitely the first conference game where we haven't been ahead in possessions. You know, we were minus 6. So against a team that efficient offensively to be minus 6, I mean, we got to come back and play them and be like plus 12, you know, and we didn't, so.
You kind of alluded to the Maryland game and this being an improvement over that. Does that show you, you know, we're getting there?
Yeah, we've been getting there. We've been getting a lot better. I mean, I think it showed through December, through January so far. I mean, you know, obviously, you know, we didn't feel like we played very well, you know, and credit Washington. But also, you know, there was a lot of things that we could have done in this game that we didn't do. But again, I can't emphasize enough. I mean, when Riley went down, that kind of did it for us. You know, and I think Kiki's doing a fantastic job, but I mean, she did nothing for a month. I mean, she is still getting her wind back, rusty, and then when we don't have a rotation to sub, you know, it's just tough for us. But, you know, Riley, the thing that Riley does, and you guys have all seen it, she just makes our offense go. I mean, she's just so poised and savvy out there and so amazing in transition. I mean, it would have been nice to finish the game with her and see how things played out, but, you know, unlucky. I think so. I mean, I don't think Diana would have put her back in, you know, if there was any risk. And obviously she didn't move well when she put her back in, so I just took her back out. I didn't want to risk it. But, you know, I think she sprained her ankle, if I had to say. I don't really know, actually, but hopefully she'll be okay. She's a tough kid. You know, I know she wanted to come back in, so, you know.
We have one more question. Thank you very much, guys.
Okay, thanks.